Hello. So, it is time for week 5 of the UBL. Let's put it this way, things haven't been going well. we're 2-2 right now, which is really dicey for playoffs. If we want to guarantee playoffs, we have to win our next 3 weeks, which is not something easy to do. Because as you can see on your screen, we're against one heck of a team. We're against Batrat and the Mexico Mimikyus. Their team consists of Zygarde, 100%, so they have power struck Zygarde, Togekiss, Smeargle, Rotom Frost, Porygon Z, Veramosa, Alolan Persian, Mega Gengar, Floatzel, Darm, Alakazam, and I think the elephant in the room, Dialga. And I bet you're wondering, wait a minute, Dialga? I thought you had Dialga. Well, we made some transactions that we'll go over shortly, but basically, we don't have Dialga anymore. They have it. Which is very, very bad for us. Batrat had Dialga Mega Gengar last season and got second with it. I'm afraid. Zygarde is theoretically very good, but not as good into our matchup as I think they'd like it to be. Togekiss, again, same deal. Darm, on the other hand, is a lot scarier for what I have. Other than that, Smeargle could be annoying. I'm expecting some kind of fake out pressure from Persian, potentially. Other than that, maybe PZ. But the main thing here is Mega Gengar Dialga. That offensive pressure is something I have to respect. And I do have to respect Darm as well. Darm is something I cannot take lightly. And it's something I don't have a lot for in prep. So it's something I'm really going to have to focus on dealing with. If and presumably when it comes. But we have some ways around it. Their team is very, very scary. Something I'm not looking forward to going up against. So, let's talk about our transactions first. Because obviously, as I said, we had Dialga, but now they have it. I made 3 transaction changes the week before, or like the time before transactions closed. Because transactions are now closed as of week 5. We made some changes. Dialga, we changed our restricted, something I didn't think I'd need to do. But with how much ground was hurting us, and how much I was, like, wanted to put off bringing Dialga just because we had too many ground weeks I wanted to bring every single week, it was too much. We couldn't keep having Dialga with us. It was bulky and it was good, but it just wasn't doing what I wanted it to. It was restricting my team building too much. As a result, a lot of my team had to change. And by a lot, I mean 3 Pokemon. So, Dialga went for a new restricted, and one I'm actually quite familiar with. It went for Kieran White. Kieran White is a monster. It has 170 special attack, way more respectable bulk than you would give it credit for. 125 HP, 90 defense, 100 special defense. That's a lot bulkier than you would give it credit for, and you'll find that out in some of the calcs today. Turbo Blaze, really nice ability. So, we can hit through things like Mimikyu Disguise. It's a mold breaker. It's a mold breaker. So, that's already nice. So yeah, Kieran's White's really nice. And I think we just may as well go over to change now. We changed Noivern for a Bomber Snow. So we have a Hail Core. It's a weak Hail Core, but I didn't want to grab a Alolan Ninetales because I didn't want to purely rely on hail. Vanillix was gone, so a Bomber Snow was the next best thing. Airstream dropped this and I sniped it immediately. I was like, I need this because now it gives me hail offense, which is why we've got some Frosty Forest music playing. We have hail as an option now, which means we can just lead these two and we have hail offense. A bomber snow is a really nice pickup, and it means we have a completely new mode to our team that I think will really help us out. We had a huge problem with grounds, and that's no longer the case. And that's why I was talking about Zygarde. I can't guarantee Zygarde is coming. Not when hail is such a potential thing to come that they have to play around. Which is also why I'm now more afraid of Dom. So, Bombasaur is really nice. It's a hail machine. It can also spam its own blizzards. So, yeah. And the last change was Konk. Konk wasn't doing as much as I wanted. It wasn't... Even when I wanted to go Trick Room, it just wasn't good enough. Like, it would deal a lot of damage, but it would just die in return. It wasn't bulky enough. It couldn't live enough, essentially. So, we changed it out, and we grabbed a new piece. We grabbed Celesteela. So, Celesteela gives us a... Gives us a different thing. A different thing? Celesteela gives us a new option. It gives us a really defensive piece, that a good steel type as well, that isn't weak to ground. It gives us another flying, but honestly, like, it's weak to fire and electric, and it's super bulky and can go offensive or defensive. This Pokemon, I think, is going to add a whole new dynamic to our team, and I think will really help us out. And I also just realized, we didn't even get rid of a Bombasnow for Noivern. We actually got rid of Tangela for it. I completely forgot, we actually had one more transaction change. We did get rid of Noivern, we actually got rid of it for Magneton. Magneton gives us another Electro-type. It gives us another Ground Weak, but it also actually gives us an Electro-type we can pair with Tapu Koko. Which I think is really nice. It gives us essentially the Electric Terrain mode I wanted in the first place. Magnet Pull has some utility, and Sturdy means it can actually take a hit guaranteed. I mean, it can fire off those powerful Thunderbolts and Discharges potentially that I've been wanting to do with Tapu Koko. So this gives us a whole extra dynamic to the team. So, that is the team changes. We made four transactions. I think these were the three initial ones. Swapping Kyurem for Dialga, swapping Konk for Celesteela. We still have a Trick Room Sweeper in Muk, so it's not like Trick Room's out of the question. I'm swapping Noivern for Magneton, because Noivern was never coming. It was just not doing enough. And then we, as soon as Airstream dropped a Bombasnow, we grabbed it up immediately. And I think this made me more comfortable. Initially, I wasn't happy with the changes, but grabbing a Bombasnow really made this feel a lot better. As for the team itself this week, I really struggled. After last week, and I felt... Basically, I felt like I didn't put on enough offensive pressure. When I played against Starlet in the OKC Onyxes, I was telling myself I needed to play aggressive with this supposedly bulky team. And in games 2 and 3, I did. In game 1, I didn't really. I didn't get the pressure that I needed. Against Airstream last week, like, I tried to play defense, and they just brought support Marowak, which Superfang and Toxic to my whole defense. So I wasn't even to... Like, my defense wasn't strong enough to counteract their own offense. So this week, I have said, screw it. If we can't be defensive, we're going offensive. So, let's start off with Kang. Kang is super bulky offense. The bulk is to make it so it can take 2 timid max special attack sludge bombs from Gengar. Sucker Punch is an almost... it's like a 93% minimum... And Low Kick does a chunk to Dialga, like 70%. The whole point is a lot of our moves are going to be like combo moves, where there's not a lot we can do to KO, like guarantee KO one thing. Because their team actually has a good amount of bulk. Things like Dialga you can't kill in one hit, it's so hard to do. But we have things that can combo into each other to make sure things are going down. Fake Out is obviously great pressure. We have Scrappy because they have a Gengar, so we can Fake Out Gengar if we want, but if they're leading things like Persian, then like we're just going to get faked out. Usually how they play with Gengar anyway is they protect turn one to guarantee you this. You're stuck in for a turn. So, yeah. But we have Sucker Punch anyway. So, if we do get a Fake Out off, Sucker Punch will probably take it out. So yeah, that's... And they're probably going to protect him from Takang anyway. But yeah, like, we have the option. There's no return this week. I wanted return, but I couldn't... Like, we needed Ice Punch, really. Do we need Ice Punch? No, I'm gonna give it return. Originally, Ice Punch was there for Zygarde, but because we have the Hail Core now, I think return is fine. Return will help chunk down Togekiss as well, which is really nice. They're the same base power, essentially. Well, return's 3 points stronger, but yeah. But it also makes things... Like, I can hit Dawn with this, which is really nice. Granted, Dawn will probably want to destroy my face, but you know. Anything to hit that Dawn is going to be nice. AV Coco. This is a super bulky AV Coco, and basically one of the only support pieces we have this week. Nature's Madness is going to be huge, because like I said, we're looking to pick up double... We're looking to pick up the, like... The 2-hit KOs. So, like, by doubling up into something. Nature's Madness is a great way to do that, because a lot of things will just do around 50%. Sky Drop will let me so it's... So it's just a one-on-one for a short amount of time. That short amount of time will be enough. The speed is actually a weird one. So this is to outspeed a Persian speed creeping a max speed Kang. So this is 2 points faster than max speed base 100s. Because I don't see them going max speed on Persian. I was going to go max speed, but I was like, there's no way they run max speed. So instead I just opt to put it all in special bulk. So we can take as little from Gengar Sludge Bombs as possible, which we take. We take as Gengar Sludge Bomb. We take like 2 Flash Cannons from Dialga or an Earth Power. Like an Earth Power and a Flash Cannon we take. It's crazy how much this Coco takes. And we can... The special attack is to make it so that Volt Switch... And originally it was Ice Punch, but like Return works as well. Volt Switch plus Return... will KO Togekiss. A max HP, max defense Togekiss with 4 special defense. Return plus Volt Switch takes it out. So if they want to follow me, I can return plus Volt Switch and just take it out. And then Electro Web, really going to be nice to speed down that Gengar. Mainly the Gengar. Because Gengar is super, super fast. Oh boy. Remember when I said I was going offense? I wasn't joking around. So this actually one-shots Gengar with Side Shock. If it's no bulk, Gengar goes down to this. Even with a bit of bulk, like, even with a little bit of HP investment that they may have, like, left over, this still may KO. Actually, is a good chance of KOing. Tailwind, great speed control this week. We want the speed. We're not going Trick Room. Because I just don't think... Like, Jelly in front of, like, Gengar is never gonna work. And we've got Earth Power with Ground DMZ. So Earth Power does a min of, like, 43% to Dialga. So, a combination of Ground DMZ plus Earth Power will take it out. And this is also, like, looking at bulky Dialga. So if it's an offensive one with speed investment... Yeah... we probably actually 2-hit KO it or just one-shot it with Ground DMZ, which is really nice. The speed is for, what's it called? It is to outspeed Smeargle, just in case Smeargle's carrying Taunt or any shenanigans. We've got the speed to outspeed it, so. Lugia's gonna be pretty nice. We also can't really play slow this week because of Smeargle. If it starts sporing everything, which I don't know if they'll bring because of, Coco, but yeah. We can outspeed it, we can make sure our Tailwind goes off. Kang Lugia is absolutely a lead I can consider. Kang Lugia, Kang Coco, Lugia, like everything's a lead at this point, except, well, Celesteela, you can kind of see the end. We can talk about Celesteela later. And when I said I was going offense, I wasn't messing around. This is something I've used before, and let me tell you one thing. Specs Cure and White doesn't mess about. Blizzard one-shots Mega Gengar with no, like, HP investment. Blizzard, which is a spread move. Earth Power does 99% to bulky Dialga. So that's almost guaranteed to go down. If Hail Chip's there, it's going down. Dragon Pulse is just for coverage, because, like, I mean, we don't even need Dragon Pulse. Dragon Pulse is just a safe move to lock into, but, yeah. I'm probably going to Fusion Flare. What am I hitting with Fusion Flare? Like, nothing? I'm not hitting anything with Fusion Flare. I'm not hitting anything with Dragon Pulse, either. What am I doing? I don't even know what else I would run. I may change this. I don't even know what else I would run. I don't want to run Focus Blast. Maybe just run Draco. Yeah, because then it gives me the power option, which also means that this actually does one-shot Dialga. I have used Specs Draco Kieran White in the past, and it hurts. Again, speed is to outspeed Smeargle, and then we've got Max Special Attack, and then the bit in bulk, I believe it's actually relevant because it means we actually live a Dom superpower. I believe it's not even just a Dom superpower. I believe it's an adamant Dom superpower is what we live actually, which is crazy to think about. That's why I was saying, like, Dom can be scary, but we actually have the bulk on this thing. That's why I was saying, like, the bulk on this thing, not something to be underestimated. We live adamant Dom superpower. With no boosting item, of course. I can expect, like, adamant scarf. Cool, like, this actually lives superpower. And then we can smash it in the face with an Earth Power or a Blizzard. Depends on, like, what mode I'm going with. Because, like, the Blizzard is there as, like, an option. If they aren't ready for hail, we can absolutely just go Abomasnow Kyurem. Which, speaking of Abomasnow, it's three ice moves and light screen. Light screen is here just as an option. Really, turn one with Abomasnow, the plan is to Icy Wind to make sure that Kyurem's outspeeding everything. And then we can click Blizzard if and when we need to. Ice Shard just to pick off anything that's on the sash. Or close enough that hail will take it out. And then light screen is just there because I don't need any grass coverage this week. So I've just gone with light screen as an option. Just if, like, I feel like I have a turn where, like, Kyurem's just gonna KO everything anyway. Like, Abomasnow's not just sitting there doing anything. A lot of the time, Abomasnow is going to be dying pretty quick anyway, so it's not like Abomasnow is, like, really going to be doing a lot. I mean, we've gone modest because, like, honestly, we don't outspeed much anyway. We may as well make the most out of our Blizzards, so... like, we can still outspeed some things. I believe at minus one, we can still outspeed, like, max speed Dialga, so that's really nice. And then last but not least, Celesteela. The only Pokemon on this team that is not considered a lead. This is always in the back, and it's always coming in the back. Every single time. The point of this is simple. We're clearing out everything that can kill Celesteela, and then we're winning with it in the late game. Leech Seed, Protect, Flash Cannon, Hidden Power Ground. The special attack is to make sure we can actually break a sub on max HP Zygarde. So, you know, we can actually Leech Seed it. Hidden Power Ground to make sure we can actually deal damage to Dialga, so we're not just Leech Seed protecting, like, as good as it is. the special defense also means that either Timid, like, funnily enough, I was looking at it, Timid, Mega Gengar, and Modest Dialga, both from, like, special attack, actually hit the same special attack stat, which is kind of interesting. But this can take two T-Bolts from Modest Dialga / Timid Gengar. With a Protect. So, like, I take one, it does a max of 55%, Protect, get the lefties gain, and we can take two. Even without Protect, we can take two, but yeah. Just because of how left... no, we'd need to Protect, yeah. Because then we hit, like, 112%, essentially. Yeah, so with a Protect, we can guaranteed live... two. So even if we miss Leech Seed, we can guarantee live two T-Balls with a Protect on our hands. So Celesteela is a mon that's coming to back. There is no guaranteed lead this week. It all depends on what they bring. this team is flexible enough to be able to just say, like, because so the problem is right now, everyone is counter-teaming. And my brain is not working enough to counter-team. Because I don't know what the heck anyone wants to do. You can't prep for a counter-team. Especially when people are bringing things like support Mega Mawile. I can't prep for that. You can't prep for exactly what people are going to be bringing when people are bringing the wildest stuff. So instead of you bring too much that they have to deal with, and if I bring on too much offensive pressure that they don't have exactly what they need to deal with it, that's the plan. I don't think you can prep for Specs Cure and White. You can try, but you can't. Like, it's going to be rough. Yeah, you also might say there's counter synergy with Lugia, but, like, the whole point is, like, if Lugia's coming, then the Bombersnow's not. Or if it is, then one of the potential options is I lead Kyurem. If I'm deterring them from bringing Gengar, then I can go Kyurem Lugia lead. Then just Tailwind. Fire off a Blizzard. And it looks weird, but then we switch into a Bombersnow and get our 100% accurate Blizzard, while Kyurem's got the speed. Or we just start going for Ice Beams and Tailwind, and then just, like, Lugia provides offensive pressure as well. So, yeah. This team has a lot of options for leads, but Celesteela just comes in the back and hopefully is our win condition. With the amount of bulk that it has... Oh, by the way, this thing never dies to, like, Zygarde. Ever. It's not dying to Zygarde ever. It takes, like, a max of 29% from Thousand Arrows. Yeah, so even if it gets a DD up, it's not even a guaranteed, like... It's not a guaranteed 2 KO. It needs 2 DDs. And if we see 100%, it's over. So... This is a super, super aggressive team. And basically the point is we beat them down so much that they don't have anything left for Celesteela. There's a lot of bulk going around as well. Like, it's not just fast offense, it's bulky offense. It's bulky offense with speed control. So, I'm very much looking forward to this. This may change as well. I may even re-record this. This team builder, because, like, I've got, like... The battle's in a couple days. Well, it's tomorrow. But I've still got work tonight, so I can easily think of something else stupid. Like, I wasn't thinking on Grand UMZ Lugia. Originally, I was going to be like, oh yeah, I'll just run Kasib and just live Shadow Ball. But I already lived the Shadow Ball as the thing. With Protect, it means we can deal with the fake out from Persian. So we can live anyway. Because we have multi-scale, we can take a Shadow Ball. We have fake out of our own, so they can't exactly go for it turn one. So, yeah, we've got a lot of options for leads, and I think this week, I'm not losing in team prep like I feel like I have been. This time, I'm losing on the field of battle. And any decisions that I make in battle are what's going to cost me. It's all about the leads, it's all about picking what's right for the matchup. I will say this now, if Dom doesn't come... This is a free win, because everything on this team kind of loses to Dom. We probably even want to max ground the Dom if it comes in. So yeah, like, that's the kind of stuff we're dealing with. Like, the only thing I could have brought was Arcanine, and even then, an Arcanine isn't gonna, it doesn't slow it down enough. It's the issue. So yeah, but it was certainly an option that I did consider, but it just didn't slow it down enough. And it was the only thing it was gonna slow down. It wasn't slowing down anything else. The rest of their team is kind of specially offensive. Because I'm not expecting Feromosa. It just dies to too much, and like, Sash is gonna get broken by hail. I'm not expecting them to bring Rotom Frost against me. Like, it just seems silly. Like, sure, they can spam Blizzards of their own, but it just doesn't seem to be good. What else was I... Oh, yeah, I don't know what Float Sleeve does. So, yeah. Like, I looked at this and I said, oh, yeah, Zygarde is coming. And then I thought about it, like, Zygarde might not come. Like, these are actually now, like, question marks. Like, these are the only two that I'm guaranteeing are coming, especially Dialga now. Now that I have, you know, Hail. But, like, Zygarde and Togekiss may not come because I have Hail. Dom actually is looking way more likely now. So maybe I do swap this Coco out. I don't know. I could easily, like, think on this and go, maybe I don't want Coco. But we'll see. So that will do it for now. I will see you guys in the battle. Or maybe a different team builder. I don't know. I've got another night to think about this, so we'll see what happens. And we're back. So, as you can see on your screen, there has been a slight change. I was considering this, and as I said, I thought about making the change, and so I did. Fatrad's turning in a challenge in a sec, but the Arcanine. It's Avian Arcanine now, with Flare Blitz, Extreme Speed, Snarl, and Crunch. The stuff for it is right here. It guaranteed lives two Rock Slides from a Jolly Dom after an Intimidate. And takes, like, nothing from Dom. We had it to have a Dom check just in case. But because it's AV, it also takes chunks from both Mega Gengar and Dialga. If we Snarl a Dialga with no boosting item, we actually live two Earth Powers from it. So, yeah. It also does pretty good chunks. The attack investment was to make sure it free hit KO'd offensive Dom with E-Speed. So yeah, that's the point here. The speed is just to speed creep anything, trying to just have four and try and speed creep no speed Dom. Oh, this is it. Let's do this. No Zygarde. That should have been expected, but they brought the Frost. They brought Feromosa as well, which I'm surprised at. There's no Dom. I could have brought Coco. I would have been fine. So I think they want to use Frost so they can use my Hail against me. But the thing is, because I have Arcanine, like, I'm not afraid of it. And this is because of a Smeargle lead. I'm gonna see if they're ready for it. Celesteel comes to the back. Because that is the whole point here. And then, is it... I don't think we need the Arcanine. I think we can go with Kang. Like, Backdoor Kang. Is there some offensive pressure? It means I won't really have speed control, though. I mean, that's fine. We see Togekiss Dialga. I will guarantee get a hit off here. I'm going to go for the Icy Wind. We see Kyurem's faster. Oh, is he setting up Trick Room? But I say that has to be Life Orb. So... So Gengar's the last thing I really need to take out. Celesteela should be able to take on any Pheromosa. So what we're going to do is we're going to scrappy fake out the Gengar. I'm going to set up a light screen. Now I'm going to Mega Run up. Go for the Sucker Punch. Fire off a Blizzard. Forgot about that. Ooh, and that's a freeze. That's a big freeze as well. Oh, but when you play with the ice, sometimes you get a little bit frozen. Okay, I have a genuine question. Make it all 50. I shot us like 17%. We see Smeargle in the back as the last. We see Fake Out come out. Take out the Togekiss. And they're just trying to do what they did to me. I don't want to give much more away. They're going to protect. Oh, don't do this to me. I'm missing returns. And I'm getting put to sleep. Oh dear. Let's not have this happen, shall we? Okay, cool. Cheers, Kang. Breaking Sashes. GG. Cool. Alright, we got game one. You can definitely say we got lucky with a freeze. But yeah. Even though Kieran went down turn one, we still destroyed that game. So I really want to mix them up here, and I want to go with Lugia Kieran. We see the Frosty Boy this time. I can just lock into Blizzard because I'm just going to Tailwind and switch. Yeah. I'm just going to Blizzard and Tailwind because I can't get trapped. Kiss goes down immediately. What's... Did I get... Did I save the calc on it? I don't think I did. I don't think it's worth it for me to switch as well. Actually, no, I'm going to switch. And I'm going to find out this. I'm going to see how bulky it is. That's not a game I want to play. We saw it's bulky, actually, because my bombers know how to spend it. We saw it's bulky. We cannot go for a Z move while this Rotom is on the field. And my Lugia gets frozen. Alright. I mean, I got a freeze game one. They go for the Alice switch again, but Lugia gets frozen, so it doesn't really matter. Tailwind goes away, we got Celesteel in the back, and they've got Gengar. It's not what we like to see. I'm not sure if they protect turn one. The Shadow Ball Lugia. Don't miss this Leech Seed. No! That Leech Seed miss was huge. That Leech Seed... I could have just gone for 200 Battle Grounds. Why didn't I just go for 200 Battle Grounds? I'm going to protect. I'm protecting for one reason and one reason alone. There's no T-Ball. There's no T-Ball. HP ground. Right? How much? How? Wait, how much does my HP ground do? To Gengar. I like his all caps. Level 50. No bulk, it does like 40%. Okay, no, we need Leech Seed on there. No drops. We get the protect, because it's not got T-Ball. We're healing on up. Get that HP ground. This is for death drop. But we heal on up. We get the protect. They debonded. I think if it dies to Leech Seed, don't die to debond. And we win. Whew. Yes! We beat Dialga. With our new power. That is the power of Kyurem. Even though I don't think Kyurem really did that much, it put on so much offensive pressure. And that is what this team needed. That's what I was thinking about going to work yesterday. This team didn't have any offensive presence. It wasn't able to just go, I'm going to send something out and I'm going to go in. And with a strong offensive pale core like this, it's something people have to be so ready to deal with. They don't have to deal with just, like trying to break through Lugia or trying to figure ways around like this weird pivoting. They've now got to not only deal with a Lugia, they've got to now deal with Celesteela, and they've got to break through the Hail Core. Yeah. This, I think, really showed it in its light, and what these new pieces really do for the team. Bless Celesteela, by the way. This was the whole point, to take down the pieces it could, that, like, bother Celesteela. I thought that Lee Seamus was going to cost me the game. But GG's to Fat Rat. Always a blast to play you. And yeah, we're now 3-2. We can still make a playoff run here. So let's do it. Let's make playoffs and let's take home the win. And that's what we're going for. So thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. So take it easy.